easily that there is a God and he's alive and he's trying to teach us some important lessons. He wants to take the mystery out of the Bible. And that applies to you individually or collectively. It makes no difference. It applies to the whole nation. But mankind is the cause of all these problems. We have brought these problems upon ourselves because there's something wrong with man. And the Bible tells you what we have to do to solve our problems. And first, we have to change human nature. That's very clear in the Bible. But look, just a little logic ought to tell us that if there is a living Creator God, He would want us to solve these problems. And you can go to any institution in this world today and they cannot give you an answer to these mysteries. They can't solve them. And they're of just towering size. And we have to solve them or they're going to overwhelm us. Is there a voice? Is there a voice crying out in this world? And has there been in the recent past a voice crying out in this world telling us how to come out of the madness of this world? You know when you look around and you honestly view what's going on in this world, there are serious problems and we should be able to solve those problems and we're going to solve them in time. But there's going to be a lot of suffering first unless we listen to God and listen to His message. These problems are going to be solved. Let me give you an example, a story that Mr. Armstrong experienced when he went to meet Indira Gandhi, the Prime Minister of India. And he was in New Delhi and he got into a taxi cab and they were driving around. He saw all these cows and oxen running around over New Delhi and he asked the taxi driver if these animals didn't stray a long way from home. And he said, well, yes, they do. And Mr. Armstrong asked him, said, well, how does the owner find them? And the taxi driver smiled and said, why, the owner doesn't find them. They know where their owner is, and they go back home. They know where their home and their owner is, and they go back. And immediately, that reminded Mr. Armstrong of a scripture that I'd like to read to you today. It's in Isaiah 1, verses 2 through 4. Here's what it says, hear, O heavens, and give ear, O earth. The earth, these are end time prophecies. Hear, O heavens, and give ear, O earth, for the Eternal has spoken. I have nourished and brought up children, and they have rebelled against me. The ox knows his owner, and the ass his master's crib, but Israel does not know my people does not consider. My people don't know me, he's saying. Verse 4, ah, sinful nation, talking to Israel, a people laden with iniquity, just laden and worn down with iniquity, sinfulness or lawlessness. It should read, they're breaking God's law. A seed of evildoers, children that are corruptors, they have forsaken the Lord. They have provoked the Holy One of Israel unto anger. They are gone away backward. They have forsaken God. Now, you can't forsake God if you never knew Him. So these people did know Him on one level or the other. Now, in ancient Israel, and Israel, of course, is the only nation that's ever known God or been led by God or have a history with God. The only nation. And they forsook God. They forsook Him. Now, God didn't offer them salvation, but He does offer salvation to spiritual Israel or the church. But in this end time, and this is an end time prophecy, God says it applies specifically to His own church. To His own church. They have forsaken God. Now you see, they do understand the spiritual and they are offered salvation. And yet God says they, on the spiritual level, have forsaken God just like ancient Israel did. We have a booklet on Isaiah, and you can write to it. It's free if you want to get it and see that proven to yourself. But first of all, God sends this message to His own people. And we've offered many times our book on the United States and Britain in prophecy. And it will prove to you who Israel is, who the United States is, and who Britain is. It will prove that to you. Now, we have also won that book, the larger version, in court as well. And we offer it to you absolutely free. We want you to have these precious truths, and they are priceless. You can't put a price on them, and we don't charge for our literature. We want you to see what your Bible actually says and what a great gift it is if you understand it and can remove all the mystery from it. But here is a horrifying picture in Isaiah 1, verses 2 through 4. God is saying the nations of Israel have less intelligence than an ox when it comes to knowing their owner. God is our owner. God is our creator. He says, look, the dumb ox knows his owner, but you don't know me. Look, this is right out of your Bible. It's right out of your Bible, and it's prophesied for the same time. You'd better think about this. Do you know God? Can we become more intelligent than the ox and the cow? Well, this is the biggest tragedy in the world today. Though people don't realize that, it is the biggest tragedy that we face today. But I want you to notice also that God calls for the inhabitants of the earth. The earth to hear this. They don't know Him. This whole world is deceived. Revelation 12 and verse 9. They don't know God. Now Israel anciently was supposed to teach them about God. That's why God puts it this way. He blames it specifically on Israel. But He says, look, this is for the whole world. Israel was supposed to take this message to the whole world. Today the church does. God's true church does take this message to the whole world. That is a commandment. And this is a message for the whole world. And this is a book for the whole world. The whole world needs to know what the Bible means and answer the biggest questions they've ever faced in their lives. They must face those and answer them. So God intended this message to get out to this world and every man, woman, and child on this earth. That's what He intended. Look, God has had problems with the educated people from the beginning. And Paul had problems with them. If you remember the story in Acts 17, he went to the Athenians and they had a monument out there for every god you could think of, and even had a monument to the unknown God. And Paul said, now, that's the God I want to talk to you about. In essence, he was saying, you don't know God. Or you wouldn't have all these different monuments. You don't know the true God. These were philosophers and scholars. And that's all they did was talk about philosophy. I mean, they spent their whole lives doing that. And Paul said, you don't know God. And I have to tell you, neither does education today. Matthew 13 and verse 15 says they've closed their minds to God. That's what the Bible says. Educated people have done that. Oh, they may say they believe in a first cause or whatever they might say, but God says they did not like to retain God in their knowledge. Romans 1 and verse 28. And that not only applies to the educated, but look, you also read Acts 1 and verse 15, where Jesus Christ, when He came to this earth, do you know how many converts He ended up with? 120. Now, Christ and God are not trying to save the world today. He's letting them learn the lessons the hard way. He's not trying to convert the world. I mean, after all, the Son of God only converting 120 people, does that make sense? And that's what happened. In fact, He spoke in parables where they could not understand because they would become converted and He would heal them and then they would fall back away again. That's what He was saying. But God says in Isaiah chapters 40 and 41, He said, look, I am the living God. I created everything, and man is nothing and can do nothing apart from Me. That's what God says. Now that's the problem. That's a big problem. Man is nothing and he can do nothing. Even Christ Himself said, I can't of my own self do nothing. He knew he had to have the Spirit of God when he was a human being on this earth to do anything. And you and I can do nothing apart from God. Nothing. Now, you see, that's where we get in trouble. Men don't believe that.